Now the question says, in a triangle ABC with fixed base BC, so that means B and C, these two points that are given, the vertex A moves such that cos B plus cos C is equal to 4 sine square A by 2. If ABC denote the sides of this triangle opposite to angles A, B and C, then which of the following option is correct? So we know that cos C plus cos D is 2 cos C plus D by 2, so it will be cos B plus C by 2 into cos B minus C by 2, and here it will be 4 sine square A by 2. Now we know that B plus C by 2 is pi by 2 minus A by 2, and cos pi by 2 minus A by 2 is sine A by 2. So we'll write 2 sine A by 2, and this is cos B minus C by 2, and it will be 4 sine square A by 2. So we'll cancel 2 with 2, and then we'll also cancel sine A by 2. So we'll get this condition, which is cos B minus C by 2, and it is equal to 2 sine A by 2. Now again, we can write A by 2 as pi by 2 minus B plus C by 2. Now sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. So it'll be cos B minus C by 2 is 2 times cos B plus C by 2. Now cos A minus B is cos A cos B plus sine A sine B. So we can write cos B by 2 into cos C by 2 and plus sine B by 2 into sine C by 2, and this is equal to 2 times. Now cos A minus B is cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. So it'll be cos B by 2 into cos C by 2 and minus sine B by 2 into sine C by 2. Now we'll take cos together and we'll take sine together. So we'll get cos B by 2 into cos C by 2, and it'll be equal to 3 times sine B by 2 into sine C by 2. Now cos B by 2 upon sine B by 2 is cot B by 2, and cos C by 2 upon sine C by 2 is cot C by 2. So we'll write cot B by 2 into cot C by 2, and this value is simply 3. Now from properties of triangle, we know that cot B by 2 is S minus B upon S minus A S minus C, and cot C by 2 is S minus C S minus A S minus B, and this value is equal to 3. Now we can cancel S minus B with S minus B and S minus C with S minus C. So now we'll get S upon S minus A equals 3. So we can write 2S equals 3A. Now 2S is nothing but A plus B plus C. So from here we'll write A plus B plus C is equal to 3A, and that is value of B plus C is equal to 2A, and that's your option number B. And this question, since BC is fixed, so that means this A is constant and these B and C, they vary. So B and C, they vary such that B plus C is equal to 2A. So we'll have this condition, which is A must vary so that AB plus AC must be equal to 2A. Now this is nothing but this is focal property of an ellipse. So which is PS1 plus PS2 must be equal to 2A. So locus of this point A, it must be an ellipse, and that's your option number C. Now the question is, point O is the center of an ellipse with major axis AB and minor axis CD. Point F is one focus of this ellipse, and if OF is 6 and the diameter of inscribed circle of the triangle OCF is 2 and the product AB into CD is K, we need to find value of greatest integer function of under root K. Now what we'll do is we'll draw this ellipse. Center is at origin and one of the focus is F, and this distance OF, it is given as 6 centimeter. Now major axis is AB and minor axis is CD. So F is say AE comma 0 and B is A comma 0, and this point C, it is 0 comma B. So the first condition that we have here is value of A is simply 6. Now it says the diameter of the inscribed circle of triangle OCF. So this triangle. So diameter of the circle, it is 2 units. So radius of this in circle will be 1 unit. Now we know that radius of in circle is delta upon S, where delta is area and S is semi-perimeter. So we write 1 as, now what's the area of this triangle? Area of this triangle will be 1 by 2 into A. A in this case is 6, and then into, this is B upon, and this is B plus 6 plus under root of B square plus 36 upon 2. So we'll cancel this 2 with 2. So we'll get B plus 6 plus under root of B square plus 36 is 6B. So we'll write under root of B square plus 36 as 5B minus 6. So if we'll square, we can write B square plus 36, and this is 25B square plus 36 minus 60B. So 36 will cancel. So we can write 24B square, and this is equal to 60B. Now B cannot be 0, so value of B is 60 upon 24, which is simply 5 by 2. Now once we have B and we have A, we can find A square also. So we know that B square is A square into 1 minus E square. So B square is 25 by 4. Now A square we need to find out. And what's A square? A square is 6 square, which is 36. So we write A square as 25 plus 4 into 36 by 4. So it'll be 169 by 4. So value of A is simply 13 by 2. So AB into CD is K, and AB is 2A and CD is 2B. So what's 2A? 2A is 13. And what's 2B? 2B is 5. So value of K is 65. Now we need to find greatest integer function of under root K. So it is greatest integer function of under root of 65. Now root 65 is 8 point something, and greatest integer function or floor function of 8 point something is simply 8. So answer to this question is 8. A variable point P on the ellipse of eccentricity E is joined to focus S and S dash. The eccentricity of the locus of in center of triangle PSS is. So we'll draw this ellipse. And then we have any point P on this ellipse, which is say A cos theta and B sin theta. Now we have two focus, S1 and S2. Say S1 is minus AE comma 0 and S2 is AE comma 0. So now we'll talk about this triangle, which is PS1 S2. Now say this distance is R1, this distance is R2, and this distance is twice AE, and we know that R1 plus R2 is simply 2A, and we also know that, and this R1 is A, 1 plus E cos theta, and R2 is A, 1 minus E cos theta. Now once we have R1, R2, then we can write locus of in center of this triangle. Now say locus of in center is alpha comma beta. So we write alpha as 2a square e cos theta plus r1 into ae minus r2 into ae upon r1 plus r2 plus 2ae. So now we'll put the value of r1 minus r2. So r1 minus r2 in this case will be 2ae cos theta. So we can write this alpha as 2a square e cos theta, and then plus ae1, and r1 minus r2 will be simply 2ae cos theta. Now we also know that r1 plus r2 is 2a, so it'll be 2a, and this is 1 plus e. Now here we'll take 2a square e cos theta common. So we'll take 2a square e cos theta common, we'll get is 1 plus e upon 2a, 1 plus e. So 1 plus e will cancel, 2a will also cancel. So we'll get alpha as ae cos theta. Now we'll write beta. It'll be 2ae into b sin theta upon r1 plus r2 plus 2ae. So it'll be 2a 1 plus e. So 2a again will cancel. So we'll get beta as eb sin theta upon 1 plus e. Now once we have alpha and beta, we need to eliminate theta. So we write cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1. So we'll get this equation as alpha square upon ae whole square plus beta square upon eb upon 1 plus e whole square equals to 1. So the locus of incenter will be x square upon ae whole square plus y square upon eb e plus 1 whole square, it is equal to 1. Now we need to find eccentricity of this ellipse. Now for this ellipse, this is say a square and this is say b square. So we can write b square as e square b square upon e plus 1 square, and this is equal to a square e square, and this is 1 minus e dash square. So e square will cancel. Now we can also write b square as a square into 1 minus e square. So we'll write a square 1 minus e square upon e plus 1 square, and this is a square into 1 minus e dash square. So a square will also cancel. So now we can write e dash square as 1 minus e square upon 1 plus e whole square. So this e dash square will be 1 plus e square plus 2e minus 1 plus e square upon 1 plus e whole square. Now here 1 and 1, it will cancel. Then we can also take 2e common. So we'll take 2e common. So it'll be 2e 1 plus e upon 1 plus e square. So 1 plus e will cancel. So we'll get e dash as under root of 2e upon 1 plus e. So eccentricity of this locus will be under root 2e upon 1 plus e. And that's your option number 1.